Bob Maloney from My MMA News, and this is the first time I have the pleasure of talking to Drew Dickson. Drew has a big fight coming up at Art of War 14. Drew, my man, how you feeling? You look happy. You must not be cutting weight yet.
That's you're about right. You're about right. I do feel good, and not really stressing that right now yet. You know what I'm saying? Probably in a few days here, we'll take care of that one, you know. But am obviously the eye has been kept on it the whole time though. So
great. Well, before we even talk, since this is the first time you and I got to chat, before we talk about the fight and the event, tell me a little bit about your background. What was it that led you into mixed martial arts and to training and actually getting in there and fighting in the cage?
Yeah. So I started wrestling in sixth grade. I played a bunch of sports. I played just about every sport growing up, but my parents put me in wrestling sixth grade, and I was kind of naturally good at it, and just kind of ended up sticking with that. Come seventh grade, I quit everything else and just stuck with wrestling, and that's just kind of where my heart was. My first time seeing fighting was probably a month into wrestling, so like right around sixth grade as well. And I'm just like, yeah, I'm gonna do that shit one day.
When did you actually start taking jiu-jitsu and other things besides wrestling? Was it after you graduated high school? When did you actually start, you know, in mixed martial arts?
Yeah, so it's kind of interesting. I did nothing but wrestling. That's all my attention was stuck on. In hindsight, I wish I would have changed it up a little bit and branched out a little bit and done some other things. What I did was I wrestled a little bit in college, and on my breaks home in the summer, I started doing like power hours at Title Boxing, like near my house. And I ended up getting tight with like the people that worked there and whatnot. And those are like, they're still my family today. And that's just kind of how I started like using my hands, just like working on a bag with a power hour and whatnot. And then like shadow boxing. I didn't hit mitts for like 2 years, and didn't even spar or anything like that. I was still wrestling and whatnot. In my mind though, I was like, I'm not going to like fully get into this, all this training until I'm done with wrestling. Cause like my heart, my mind was like, I'm trying to accomplish something in wrestling, you know? But as it comes to like jiu-jitsu and whatnot, so I took my first fight on 3 weeks' notice, and I just literally when I took the fight, I just started doing jiu-jitsu. Like I think that day or the next day, I'm like, all right, kind of got to do something. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of how it went. You know.
Tell me a little about what's the name of your fight team? Where do you train at? And who were your instructors?
Yeah, so it's kind of been a little funky, man. I won't lie. My first five fights, I walked to the cage with just one guy only. His name's RJ Hickey, and he is like one of the main managers at that Title Boxing. He has been, to me, he wears many hats, I feel, you know. He's like my brother, kind of a mentor, you know, and then I take him as, you know, a coach and whatnot to the cage. His first time cornering was my first time fighting. And so I would definitely say my first five, six fights, even seven, I was basically just an independent fighter. I did a lot on my own, and me and him worked together and whatnot whenever we could. And it wasn't really even that much, but I think he just understood that, like, I'm disciplined enough to get my own work elsewhere, you know? When I first started doing jiu-jitsu though, I started with a team, smaller team out of like Akron, Ohio, cause I went to school at Kent, and, they're called GT BJJ, and that's kind of where like I did all my rolling at. I had a buddy that I went to college with who ended up getting into jiu-jitsu and ended up loving it, and he got me to come over there, and that's kind of where I did my rolling at for probably, I think I would say, my first five, six fights until like I had to move out of Kent. I'm still tight with them, and I try and get down there whenever I can, but I don't really roll with them as often as much anymore, sadly, but they keep their door open to me whenever is possible, and I appreciate them a lot. But yeah, that's where I did kind of like my rolling at. I also work with Dave Graff over at Aries Combat. Not in there all the time, but I was in there like a decent amount more for this fight camp when I could be, when I had the time away from work as well. But yeah, I would say for the most part, I was definitely an independent fighter for just kind of structuring stuff on the go a lot and kind of what felt right for my first seven fights, you know? And,
well, listen, you're doing something right. I mean, you're 6-1, so, you know, even though you were independent, you have that wrestling background. I'm sure the wrestling has gotten you through a lot, just probably because you can probably, you know, beat a lot of guys, take them down. Obviously, you probably want your striking to obviously reach up to there with your takedowns.
Yeah, I do want to get the striking there. I want the striking to follow, you know. But, you know, it takes time. It takes experience. And it's something that, like, that I understand, you know. Like, when you're good at something, they say, you know, you need your 10 years, you know. And I feel like I have my 10 years of wrestling. I don't even, like, wrestle too much anymore, you know what I'm saying? Still do, like, I mean, like, you get it with your jiu-jitsu and whatnot, but, like, I don't, like, stress training wrestling that much just because it's been there, and I've done it for a while, you know, but, like, it's obviously needed and whatnot. We do it, but yeah, like, it's like you got to get the 10 years with the hands now, you know, and listen, it just comes from experience.
Are you a film watcher? Listen, you're fighting Anthony Caschera, who is 4-0. He has a wrestling background like you. He's the same way. He's coming along with his strike, and this is a phenomenal matchup. I can't wait. Yeah. I mean, this could very easily be fight of the night because both of you guys are elite athletes, blue chip prospects. I mean, I think both of you guys are probably going to have successful pro careers. This may be a fight where you guys fight as amateurs, and then you guys could also meet again as pros because you are both that good. Did you watch his fights? You don't care? How does that work for you? What do you know about Anthony?
So I've kind of taken on when the fight's kind of proposed to me and whatnot, the route I take typically is I'm going to look him up and I'm just going to kind of look at the basic info and whatnot, basically their fight resume. So, like, let's say like a Tapology or something like that and get an idea of who it is. And then I'll check a YouTube. And I'll see if I can find the latest fight. I'm going to watch the latest fight. And I'm kind of going to ignore the rest. I think he has like 3 on there I was able to watch. He's a tough dude, man. I didn't watch all of them, though, off the rip. And I accepted this fight on 3 months out. I've never accepted a fight 3 months out. And I've never even imagined myself doing it, unless if it was for something like professionally for something big, you know. I never expected to take an amateur fight 3 months out, but I just felt the opponent was worthy and whatnot, and the circumstances were right. But like I said, I watched the last fight once or twice. Like, all right, yeah, done. Let's get this one on paper if we can do it, you know. Let's get it going. And then what I do is I take like about 3 weeks out. I'll just take one day and I'll binge everything, just watch everything. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't know. I just want to go off that last fight and what the basics I know, and then we'll watch everything so I got an idea. But yeah, no, I watch film. You should watch film, but I don't like keep up on it and stay going with it. You know what I'm saying? I just got to see, basically, you know.
Oh man, I can't wait. This fight. This is a great fight. Listen, Art of War. Yeah. I'll be commentating, and
you know. I'm looking forward to meeting you and Mike, man. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, Mike puts on a great show, and he has some of the, you know, I'm thrilled that you're fighting for Art of War because it's another great talent and a prospect. Before we go, Drew, give out any shout-outs or any love. If you have any sponsors, anybody who's, you know, giving you some moral support, anybody who's going to be there rooting for you to have your hand raised at the end.
Yeah, man, we're coming out about 6 hours, trying to get as many dogs as we can to come out as possible, but you know, maybe, you know, hopefully 15, 20 people, including who walks with me and comes to the corner and whatnot. But people I want to give a shout out to that had their hands in on this camp is definitely my main cornerman, my brother RJ Hickey, who's been with me from the beginning. I want to give a shout out to Dave Graff because he's done a lot with me leading into this fight, and I'm assuming we're going to do more going forward. I want to give a shout out to Wilkins Santiago, who is a pro boxer out in the area this way, and he put me through some tough workouts. And I also want to give a shout out to I was able to bring in a strength and conditioning coach for this fight for the first time. We didn't overdo it. We didn't underdo it. You know what I'm saying? I just went with what we felt was needed, you know. And his name's Ryan Richmond at T3 Performance in Avon, Ohio. And I've known Ryan for a few years. I actually did an internship there going into my last year of college. So I know a lot of people over at that gym. It's a legit place, you know. But Ryan Ryan's definitely a solid friend, and he was probably the first person I thought of when I said, let's get someone who I think who knows their shit, you know?
Well, listen, Drew, best of luck to you in your final preparations. If you do have to cut any weight, have a safe trip. I know you said you got a six-hour drive, so have a safe trip. I can't wait to see you do your thing. This is going to be awesome, and like I said, it was a pleasure talking to you, and we will see you soon, man. Art of War 14, Drew Dickson, baby.
Appreciate it, man. Thank you for having me. Can't wait.